Okay, we are back, and I want to check out this exciting rocket room. Anything from here, at least not at the moment. Oh, let's convert all this. Charge packs into small energy cells. You sure are my cheaper fellow, aren't you? Other bots go.
Dr. Grant? What the hell do you think you're doing?
Ah, Whitley. There you are. Orders from Colonel Autumn. He feels the iBot DuraFrame project isn't advancing quickly enough. I'm too.
You didn't even disengage his damage avoidance protocols. You're hurting him!
Don't be ridiculous. It's just a machine. See here, I've already increased the navigation system's efficiency by 65%.
Get the hell out of here!
Fine, Whitley. It's your lab. At least until I tell the Colonel about this.
Oh. Okay, but what about the colonel? Colonel, let's see. Yes. Oh, okay, I can't access the questions anymore. Thank you. Sentry bot. Okay. That's the weapon that I saw earlier, down there. I'm gonna go back and grab it just in case. Other way here. Oh, of course, there is no other way. There's just some stuff down there. Oh fuck. Oh, did I get stuck? Oh shit. I was gonna say that this reminded me of the reactor room in Stalker. I mean doors. Reload. Okay, so where were we first? I still wanna look down here, but I'm not stepping in there again. Charge packs, wasn't it? Yep. Oh, and I also wanted to... which way is up? Here. I also wanted to grab that. Here. Yeah, sure. Much wonder. And I'm gonna good to tell you right now. Okay, and now new quick save here. Let's hear it.
Dr. Grant? What the hell do you think you're doing?
Ah, Whitley, there you are. Orders from Colonel Autumn. He feels the iBot DuraFrame project isn't advancing quickly enough. I'm too.
You didn't even disengage his damage avoidance protocols. You're hurting him!
Don't be ridiculous. It's just a machine. See here, I've already increased the navigation system's efficiency by 65%.
Get the hell out of here!
Fine, Whitley. It's your lab. At least until I tell the Colonel about this. I'm aware that the security is on.
Primary systems offline.
Offline, okay. Collection of those, but I did give most of them away to Cass when I was doing the caravan quest. Oh, what the hell? Drop it if I don't need it. these, the locals. What about them? See. I smell enclave. Well, the NCR told me that if I was serving, I would be halfway to general by now. I wonder if this counts. Well hung for a moment. I wonder if Prim Eddie is like the adult version of the Eddies. Thank you. kept all the quest item clothing, quest clothing items, in case I had to leave stuff behind. I deserve my first manual save here. And let's check out the rest of the shit. Okay, turrets. The locals. All seem to be after something. So I wonder, are these like missile silo goons or something? Evolved there or something? Yes. Out all sorts of stuff before I switch on any mainframe anywhere. Ah, but I can't. Oh, okay. So not that easy. Let's see. Well, there's all sorts of stuff. Thank you. I suppose once the doors are open, all sorts of bad guys will come in. Oh yeah. Scenes anymore, so too lazy to.
Conviction, courier. one head then. Better off for it. Their flag speaks to their spirit. They're split like any two-headed animal, trying to go in different directions, ending up nowhere. In the Mojave, that'll only get you sand between your fingers or over your grave. The robot with you. All of them are machines, radios, old-world tech reshaped with new hands, historians, couriers carrying messages. Seen them as I've walked the divide, tending other machines. That one, sealed inside the Hopeville silo. Sign America is waking up. It will follow you, obey you, carry it until we are face to face. Then there'll be no more need for it to carry my words. The divide. This place is a slice of it. Old military. Can still smell the pride and the fear. Hope of the old world, wrapped in fencing, covered in storm. Got new inhabitants now, other than ghosts. More recent recruits. America sleeps in the divide. Giants beneath the earth. You saw one locked in the silo beneath you. There's more. Only takes a few of them, locked below ground, to tear apart the earth and cast dust, sand, ash into the skies above. For now, eyes alert, watch the streets below. There's still life in the divide. Threats other than the storms and wind. New inhabitants. These new inhabitants, not natives, most of them, came with duty, purpose, ready to kill each other. The divide was stronger. Left marks on them too. Not bear, not bull. Now, creations marked them, made them equal in history's eyes. As vicious as the storms are, these shadows of Legion, of NCR, silhouettes of things to come. If you saw their corpses, you saw mercy, got what they deserved, coming to the divide. The bear and bull, NCR Legion, came in waves before and after, right into the invisible fires, the wind, ground, collapsing beneath them. Once under different flags, now they are equal in their hatred of the trespassers, you and I.
Okay, so I take from this that the environment here is indeed toxic or otherwise hazardous.
Even as the fires here burned them from within, the winds of the divide tore their skin, exposed them, screaming to the sky. And just as the divide tears at them, so they tear at each other, for sport, like some tribal scarification. Falling back to their history, maybe. No matter what they suffer, the radiation, fire of the divide, sustains them, makes them stronger. There's truth in your words. In what I've seen of their tactics, movements, recovery, those wounds, they couldn't live otherwise. The divide winds have torn the skin from many of them. Maybe the radiation is the only thing keeping them walking. Make camp near silos, warheads. No way to cleanse the radiation. Makes them hard to kill there. Have to draw them out.
Okay, so there's sort of special advice about the locals.
America sleeps ahead of you. Its nightmares filled with quakes, storms. You'll need to find your own path. That means waking America's spears up from their slumber. There's ways. Warheads set off collapse. Warheads could open the gates again. You are resourceful. That machine, robot with you, can help you find the warheads you need to destroy. And their trigger, the detonator. The way ahead is below. The tools are there. The rest, up to you.
Okay, but he still hasn't answered why he needs me for all that. And also, from what I have gathered from the other side scenarios, he's basically my nemesis, or should be. So what's the deal with that?
Who are you who do not know your history? You came all this way for answers. Only currency I have, nothing else to be gained. Could turn around, walk away at any time. If history matters to you, you'll need to earn it. Any laws of mine, I have already cast away in the divide. They're lost to you. For now, find the trigger for the warheads buried in Hopeville. Use it to keep moving and keep alive. No courier would go to the divide, but you will, and that's what sets us apart. We walk roads no other courier will walk. And for you, you'll want to see your home one last time, see what happened. You're curious. You walk, leave ruin in your path. You can't leave alone. Still, the choice is yours. What I offer is the last I offer you. I don't care if you walk the divide. Turn, walk the Mojave, fight beneath the flags. But you will wander. If you don't, the divide will come to you and the Mojave. That will be my message to you, like the message you had for me. The divide will send its worst against you. It may break you. We'll see if you're stronger. Road gets rougher from here, courier. Left marks for you. Colors will tell the way if you're smart. They'll lead you to your home one more time. Lead to the ending of it. Maybe remind you why you wander.
It's all reverse psychology here, I get it. So basically, while this scenario doesn't have any of the, well, so to speak, physical commitment devices. It is much more sneaky, in that I could walk away any moment. And of course I won't. Explosions. The villa here too, there are areas of different hazard. Okay, is this random or is this information? First, I couldn't figure out what the atomic perk did, but then I started noticing that when I exited the area, when I exited the radiated area, then footsteps slowed down. So then I realized that it was my movement speed, not necessarily the action speed, that was reduced. sneaking. Whoever is out there is ambushing probably. Whoa. Works. Oh yes, it does. Just because I took one down doesn't mean I should rush in.